is a symptom, maybe felt transitory, maybe felt in association with all these conditions. In a condition like Vatika Pandu, this is the best picture. Vatika Pandu, have you seen somebody? You haven't seen somebody dying with renal failure? Renal failure is categorized in Ayurveda as Vatika Pandu. The hypertension in the renal failure is due to the atirukshana that I told, constriction of the circulatory pipeline, giving a pseudo presentation of hypertension for which more medicines are given, early the patient dies. I remember a lecture, I was lucky to attend a lecture on the renal failure by Dr. Mani. You may be knowing him, Dr. Mani. The creator of the chain Apollo Hospitals. Nephrologist of Mr. Jay Prakash Narayana. I was able to attend his lecture on renal failure. And since whatever bar diagram he showed, and he was himself revolving in the bar diagram like a jalebi, and finally he told one thing. He said, many times the patient is referred to me for renal transplant, not responding to any treatment given, consuming a lot of tablets in a day. I admit him, I stop all his medicine, and the patient responds very well. He was 75 when he was delivering this lecture. And in a full house of 1,200 plus in front of him, I was the only one who stood up and clapped on his statement and said, "Alas, doctor, at least at the age of 75, you understood that your tablets are killing the patient, not the patient is being killed of the disease." The unnecessary stuff you are giving him is killing the patient. The pathology of which you have not understood at all. And you said, "You are a nephrologist? Should I call you that?" I have to, because he was the Reverend Nephrologist of Jay Prakash Narayan. He must have many more to his credit. But this is the fact. So, other bleeding disorders. One day our principal, Dr. Joshi, as I said, when we were discussing about the Rakthapitta, that it exists or not, he ran at 2 o'clock his lecture, he ran into the classroom, age 62, he just ran into the, "Man, I found Rakthapitta exists. What is purpura? That is Rakthapitta. I was just reading Sushruta Sanhita." And he said, "Yes, Rakthapitta exists. Purpura can be taken as the Rakthapitta, Tiryagamana. Right? So, ITP, retinal bleeds, cerebral bleeds, colonic bleeds, and where not? You name the place, it is Rakthapitta. Then, coagulative disorders, Saktam Raktam, as I told you earlier, Raktam Saktam, Urasi Kanthe, as told by the Charaka. But why only Urasi and Kanthe? Why not anywhere in the body? It is Saktam, it is Raktapittam. So, you can treat all this. My friend's mother, he brought to me. Mother is complaining of vertigo. Doctor did that carotid Doppler, and her left carotid was blocked. Since the carotid bulb up to the opening of the internal carotid, branching of the internal carotid, all the patch was blocked. So the blood supply was cut down by 25%, or rather more. And she was feeling the symptom. And then he came, hey, yaar, kya karna hai? How to tackle with this problem? It's a simple problem, man. Just 4 to 5 centimeters of block. Why are you crying so much? Give me a couple of months, I will open it. No problem with it. I started working. Her giddiness reduced day by day by day. After 2 months, I sent her for the carotid Doppler. And the doctor telephoned me, what are you doing? Oh, mai kya ki baat hai paape? Hua kya hai ye to bata? Mere ko itni yaad karke gaali kyon de raha hai? And then he said, man, the block is not there. Her carotid is open. Both the carotid patent and normal conduction rates are seen. Couple of months, sufficient time. This is what? When you read the book, and when you read the book, between the words, here every word is a sentence, and you have to read between the words. If you read between the words, you are there. Everything is possible for you. Divinity, 1.5 months. That poor girl, after delivery, was given a heavy dose of progesterone for stopping the blood, and she was complaining of severe leg pain, edema, total dorsal vein blocked. Who mere paas aayi? I gave her the medicines and said, go, after 8 days you start rope skipping and your pain will decrease. The pain decreased. Within 1.5 months, I sent her back to the for venous Doppler. It was clear. No problem with it. It's easy. if you see it in a different perspective. Chashma badal ke dekho. Chashma badal ke dekhoge to duniya rang rangili nazar aayegi. Change your perspective and then you can see the picture better. So, one more. Sorry, I have not been able to bring the pictures and reports of all the patients treated because may amount somewhere around about 500 to 600 patients whose blocks intra extra venous are removed. Difficult to carry all the things, but some striking things I am giving you. There came a boy with a zoospermia and vomiting the blood with a cirrhotic liver, shrunken liver, and when the Doppler was done, he was having a 15 to 17 centimeters intraportal vein block due to blood coagulation, having esophageal varices of grade 4, bleeding, and he was brought to me. I said, okay, let me tackle it. And after 7 months, I was able to remove the total portal vein block, portal vein reopening without a damage. वो भाई दे ब्लॉक निकालो बोला तो पूरी पाइप ही बदल डाली, ऐसा नहीं किया है. I have not removed the pipe. I have kept the pipe intact and removed the block. Not dealing with the patency and the structure of the pipe anywhere. This was possible with the Rakthapitta Chikitsa. The Kshara, which are mentioned there in the Charaka Sanhita, again, like you, I am not going to spoon feed. Correct? You have to go and read the book. I am here to open your eyes, not spoon feed you the formulas. Whatever is available to you, go get it, start working, create miracles, have an S class, no problem. So no problem with it, you can do that. Next slide please. The bleeding and clotting factors, as it was blamed when I was studying the Ayurvedic sciences, don't know the physiology, that they have not included the bleeding factors and clotting factors in their syllabus. Where are they? And this one, our reverend teacher, who always told about the shloka for the whole year. What?
dhatur dhatur prasichyate.
In the last month, he changed his sloka and came to this sloka. Vaidurya mukta manigairiganam mruchanka hema malako dakanam madhu dakasyekshura sasyapanam panachamam gachati raktapittam. Can you perceive it? All the things in this shloka are the different coagulation factors. You are supplying them from outside in the form of medicine. And who the hell says that Ayurveda is not knowing the bleeding and coagulating factors? As I said, you can save a patient very nicely, and you can kill anybody without shooting him. Dangerous art. You can do right anything, and no law in the world can trace you and book you, because the lawmakers are not worthy of what this vidya is really. Correct? Next, the chikitsa chikitsa sutra of Rakthapitta is having wide applications, and its treatment is unique. See, Abhi, somebody was telling me, how is it possible to reduce all the dosages of antihypertensives in a day? No need, rather. That's what I told him. Just go on correcting the pathology, the blood pressure will drop. As it touches normal, reduce the dose half of the tablet. It will increase to some extent. Keep the treatment continuing. Again it will touch the base. Reduce the tablet. Again it will go up. One day, the patient can be totally converted on your treatment, and your treatment is to be stopped as soon as the correction in the liver done and the protein molecules restored back to their original status. So this is the plan for curing or offering a cure in hypertension, so called, for other chuchatak hypertension, like the hypertension in pregnancy. The single day uttama matra sneha pana is sufficient to cure the hypertension in pregnancy. Right? Where is it given? Who are the uttama matra sneha? Unamattah krichra mutrascha gaadha varcha sayyavacha. Gulimina sarpa daushtascha. Visarpa upahatascha. And those who are sneha are garbhinya stalu shoshinya. The sneha include garbhinya talu shoshinya. So, this is safe medicine to employ the ghee in whatever, however may be the blood pressure of the patient. Safely give the uttam matra dose. Uttam matra. How much is the uttam matra? Hmm? don't give me textual answers, I am not going to pass you. I am not your examiner. How many ml? Huh? What is the average dose? Must be something. Madhyama matra. Can jump up, can be reduced. No, sorry. You have not gone through the text. It appears in the Bhava Mishra's commentary on Chakradatta in the Udaradhyaya. He says, Ashtaupala Netra Madhyama Matra. Ashtaupala. Roundabout, you can't say, roundabout 350 to 380 ml. Ashtaupala Netra Madhyama Matra Snehasya. Simple. It happens, but you have to read. Read and read. Never think that you have mastered the text. Even today, if I open the Charaka Samhita, my bad luck, I can't read beyond half a page. Because it always gives me some new clues. It always gives me some new thinking. Where to copy this item and where to paste it and how to use it. And I am not able to read it totally. When I was a student in postgraduate, I was told by my seniors, hey ma'am, I read the Charaka for 18 times in 3 years. I said, you are great, sir. Me not able to read even a single time. But today I am able to do many more things than the guy who boasted he has read the Charaka for 18 times. My appreciation is clear. That's given in Panchatantra. Lambate yamshatadhi sahasradhishchapi eva saha. Ek buddhi aham priye viharami sukhe jale. Isn't it given? It took something, understood? Lambate cha shata buddhi sahasra buddhi api eva saha. Ek buddhi aham priye viharami sukhe jale. Mere ko bahut jyada nahi aata. I'm not a Vidwana, just a student. All days, all new clues coming to my brain. I don't know where, how many lives I have to get to understand the Charaka Samhita. It's really difficult. Every time you read it, gives you a new clue. Every time you read it, gives you a new clue. And you are better, better and better. Always better. So coming, and can very easily be converted into Shonitaja Vikara. This is the worst idea out of that. You saw that Shonitam Twati Dushayati in the Samprapti. And when the Shonitam is Atidushta, See, the shonitaja vikara can be generated. This is a specific stage in the existence of the Rakthapitta that it goes a shonitaja. And you mean by shonitaja? Anybody? Shonitaja? No sir, no sir. Criteria to declare a disease is shonitaja. Shitoshna snigdharukshadyaihi upakrantascha yegada samyak sadhya na siddhyanti. Raktajamstan vibhavayat. From that point onwards they are called as shonitaja or raktaja. That is the absolute condition of medicine resistance. Where all the medicines given don't work, don't create any effect on the patient. And yes, this state can be reached early in Rakthapitta because Shonitam Twati Dushayati is the basic criteria. So, that you can see in the patients. Patient says, earlier I was given one tablet, 12.5 mg. For 5 years, the doctor said the tablet is not sufficient for you, increase the dose to 25 milligrams. 4 to 5 more years, increase the dose to 40 milligrams. Now he says, this agent is not working on you, we'll change the tablet, more tablets are added. What does it indicate? The patient is going day by day to medicine resistant state. And the doctor is not declaring him a medicine resistant hypertension. And by the time he says that it's a malignant hypertension, sir, this malignant hypertension stage is the shonitaja raktapitta or the shonitaja avastha of the raktapitta. So don't think ki gulab jamun hai koi bhi utha ke kha jayega. S class mein baithne ka sapna dekho, bura nahi hai. मगर हाल वही है कि जस्ट फ्यू मंथ्स अगो आई गॉट माय पसात पसात वोक्सवैगन ब्यूटीफुल कार. यू कैन फॉरगेट एस क्लास फॉर पसात. ड्राइव इट द स्पीड ऑफ 180 kilometers on Indian roads, reaching Bombay in 1 hour 10 minutes. That's all is possible. Safely. Anything can go wrong in the world, but nothing can touch you. You can hit anybody, you can hit anything in the world, anything in the world can hit you. पर अगर आपके बॉडी पे खरोच भी आई तो कंपनी पूरा पैसा वापस देगी. इट्स दैट सेफ. पर ये याद रखना कि माय फ्रेंड सेड, फ्रेंड यू आर सीमिंग टायर्ड, व्हाट इज द रीजन? साले अंदर बैठने के लिए इतना दौड़ना पड़ता है कि कि अंदर बैठते हुए हुलिया खराब हो जाता है. Takes a lot of work to be done, a lot of brain work, and that is more tiring than physical work. It's easy, but out. It's a good idea. You can do that. And this medicine, the resistant disorders, still you can do it. Even if it's a medicine resistant or malignant hypertension, the one who can give a cure is Ayurveda. Nobody else can dream of breaking the medicine resistance. And what is the treatment? This is a fishy thing. Kuriyat chonita rogeshu raktapitta harim kriyam. In the medicine resistance, you have to operate the Rakta Pitta Harim Kriyam. The treatment, as narrated in the Rakta Pitta chapter. And yes, Virekam Upavasam Cha Mokshanam Shonitasya Cha. Sravanam Shonitasya Cha. Virekam upavasam cha sravanam shonitasya cha. So if it goes to malignant hypertension, upavasam first, then virekam, then sravanam shonitasya, again upavasam, and with the other treatment given, you can easily break the medicine resistance. And then one more thing to be applied that comes from the Sushruta Samhita. Once Garuda got a lot of visha inside, he drank, just consumed in liters. And when he was given the medicines were not effective on him. And he was dying. And then all the Dhanvantari and other the consultants of the god, they were fumbled that even the Agada is not working on Garuda. Is he going to die? And when they asked, Vishnu told them, go to Divodasa on the earth and he will suggest you something. And they came to Divodasa and asked him why the medicines are not acting on him. What's the reason? Divodasa said, the medicines you are giving are right, but before giving it to the Garuda, close his eyes and then make him drink the medicine. It will work. And the Garuda lived out of the acute toxicity. The same way, if the oral medication route doesn't work, in the medicine resistant raktapittam, you have to operate the other way. You have to give the basti. So, the treatment may not be quite simple. Never forget to do the periodical checkups of anti-CCP antibodies and ANA quantitative analysis before treating the patient of malignant hypertension, along with free T4 levels. because that is the killing idea in malignant hypertension treatment. Everything is blocked, metabolism blocked, body abruptly goes on secreting the thyroxine to increase the metabolic rate. The thyroxine, even not able to work on the body, is stored in the circulation. And if by mistake you remove the block which is blocking the medicines, the first thing to work on the body is the thyroxine in the patient, and your patient may be no more within 1 hour. So, be careful. Be careful. Treating a medicine-resistant hypertension or medicine-resistant Rakthapitta, you should be patient and bold enough. Because breaking of all the antibodies, anti-CCP, anti-DXDNA, anti-RNA, it creates a lot of heat production in the body and the patient complains of intense burning. If you can't control it, he will land into acute renal failure. So be sure, be competent, be vigilant, use your brain, and you can be there. Any medicine resistant disease, you can handle. Okay? So this was for Rakthapitta and Shonitaja Rakthapitta. The Balaprapti treatment of Rakthapitta, where it ends after the Shonita Prasadana have been achieved. After the color of the patient from tip to toe, from face to the toes, should be single tone color, no change in the color tone. Until then, you can't declare the patient to be cured. That is the Shonita Prasadana. What is the Shuddha Shonita? Prasanna Varinendriyam Indriyartha Nichantam Avyahata Paktruvegam Jitendriyam Buddhi Balopapannam Vishuddha Raktam Purusham Vadanti. Correct? Unless and until that status is achieved, your patient is not totally cured and you can't stop the treatment. Correct? At least at some level of, you may stop active treatment, but something for the Shonita Prasadana is to be consumed. And the patient asks the usual questions. How long I have to take the treatment? And my answer in the clinic is, see, you are having 5 liters of circulating blood, 2500 spare stored in your spleen, 50% buffer, great machine. 50% buffer. Who works more than that? And I can filter with active treatment to a max of 400 ml per month. If nothing goes wrong, you follow everything strictly, I can filter 400 ml per month. Now you calculate how many months you have to put in. Simple chemistry. I will help you with the virechana by removing the bulk at a time. That may reduce some time But the average time to treat will not be less than 18 months if you follow the instructions and the treatment strictly. Correct? And in case of malignant hypertension or medicine resistant state, don't ask. I am not Jyotishi. Let me work calmly. If I make any haste on your request, the effect will be, you will be dead. Not more than that anything. So keep quiet. May take couple of years, may take 3 years even to break the medicine resistance and keep you alive and come out. But that's possible idea. Now I have round out more than 10-11 se to jyada ho gaya nahi guru bhaiya. 10 to 11 and more patients of medicine resistance totally cured from different diseases. And that can be done. Alright? So, bala prapti and varna prapti, that should be achieved. How should the patient see? Stand in front of the basin with a mirror in front of you. Keep the light source behind you. Pull your nose off ear. See the color of your own blood. If it is matching the normal blood spectrum color, you are cured. Simple idea. Thin layer of blood. Just double skin and a layer of flowing blood. Simplest way to observe it. You don't need a laboratory. Simple laboratory, open eyes, you can see the color. Aage chale, kuch hai bacha? Haan, some comparison for you. I don't think I have to talk a lot, little about it. Just go on reading and everything is else is told. When you finish, tell me. Okay, so this is the plain point blank comparison of the two approaches. '94 mein mere paas pehli lady aayi thi. She came to me for hypertension. I said, yes, I will work. I started working. Her BP came down gradually. Day one, she registered with me, it was 180, 110. After 7 days, it was 160, 104, 5, somewhere. And gradually, it went on coming down up to 90. It was 140, 90. After 4 months, and she complained, "Aap kya dawa kar rahe? BP to badha hua hi hai. 140-90 is hypertensive, my doctor said." All right, he may say, but what he don't explain you is that whatever medicine he gives you for hypertension starts working only when the diastolic blood pressure crosses 100. until then he is blindly giving you tablets. His tablets are not working on you, but rather killing you. Still you want to say? And I have gradual per week registered your blood pressure. It's coming down. Now what you want to say? You want a cure or want a tab? Then she said she wants a tab. She is not interested in cure. She wants a replacement of the tab by Ayurveda. Then I said, do one thing. Leave my clinic as soon as possible. Otherwise you will not walk out. I will kick out. I am not doing that bloody job. These guys did for 100 years. I am not going to replace you the treatment. I am not going to replace you your tablet. That's not my approach. That's not my scientific approach. If you want a cure, it's here with me. If you want a replacement, go anywhere else, not me. Haji, aapne kaha na, ki patient ko aushadh kaal mein dawa lene se problem hoti hai. Why? This is the scientific time you have to take this medicine. And why should I bend the science for you? It's you who want a cure, not the science wants you. No difference in the science whether you are alive or not. If you want a cure, this is the way for a cure and you have to follow it. Even after knowing the thing that the tablet is killing the patient, the doctor is giving the same tablet and saying that he is helpless. At least you are not helpless. You are helping the patient, and if he is not willing, you can simply kick him out. Just kick one out and nobody will complain you about the timing and dose of the medicine. Everybody coming in will be knowing it very nicely that he can be kicked out. No relaxation in the schedule. This is schedule and you have to follow. Simple idea. Alright? Next one. Last one. It has the potential to do anything with anything. You can do many things. That's all. Next one, I think it's an empty slide. Next one, that's references. And next one. Thank you. I think I finished early. So, that's something I had for you. It's a total medicine resistance, everyone. Even the Ayurvedic medicines don't work if you give. That is total medicine resistance. And you can take the patient out of that condition even. This is the wonder. I think I finished early, but Higher. These are playing with energy. They are energy pockets. They can be created, but to create them, you need a lot of energy inside you, and then you can create an energy pocket. So, on a rough way, I told that don't do this. It's not for everybody, not possible by everybody, but can be created. Rather, you can feel the energy. If your energy level increases, then you can feel the energy. And then you can convert and play with the energy. But it's a dangerous idea to play with the energy. Don't try to play unknowingly. Because playing with the energy is not a simple job. It can hit you back as well. Yes, anything more? Pan laga do, wahi ek ka dukka. There are some pictures of the retinal bleed which I covered, and they are showing it here. Akshigata Rakthapittam. This is an insulin dependent diabetic with retinal bleed. Check out the dates on which the photographs are taken. Next one. This is huge bleed. Huge bleed on this macula, huge bleed on a better bleed on this macula. Next slide. That is last slide. That is totally cured. Just before that. This is the less bleed macula. Cleared. That is the scar of the bleeding, which was there. Bleeding not there. Reabsorbed. And now medicines are given to remove the scar so that he can see nicely. Yeah. 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 You see the patient walking, and there is a typical hopping walk. The patient is coming to you. Watch the patient. The walk is a hopping walk. Just his movements are not soft. Just like this, not soft. Waiting, and he is waiting unknowingly in his walk. The pain which he feels is always somewhere here, 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 or here. He is not complaining of pain here. Additionally, he is giving you a symptom. It's difficult for him to walk when he sits for some time and then tries to walk. Initially, there is a stiffness in the muscles which is stopping him. And this patient is not of a joint pain. This patient is of Rakthapitta. Because these all muscles which you saw, these are big muscles. Raktajaha, Kandarasira, these are big muscles. Big muscles are the side product of blood. So, when the shonitam dushayati, when the blood is disturbed, the reflection first is in the kandara or the big muscles, and that is causing the hopping gait. Not only Siraveda, all the medicine has to be done, his liver has to be taken care, blood purified, all the vyayama he has to do, and the patient comes to me with a joint pain and I give him medicines, and within a week or so I ask him to start rope skipping. Why? The rope skipping operates the peripheral hearts, as it is called, the calf muscles of your body, which helps your chest heart to improve the circulation, and as the circulation improves, the blood which is accumulated in his muscles get released and he is walking normally. You were to ask something. Yes. Yeah, yeah. Which liver? No, it's told in the liver, told in the text, and if you do a fibroscan of the liver of hypertensive, you can see the changes. You can get the fibroscan score before treatment, after treatment, and you can see the difference when you treat it textually. You can see the difference that the fibroscan score is improving. And that's how, that's what he says, that the shonita vahanam srotasam shonita bishanda guruni. You can't see a perfect block which is seen in the form of, seen on the sonography, normal sonography, because it's not a block of some permanent type, some stone. It's a transitory block or flow block. The flow has slowed down. And since it has slowed down, the compressibility of the liver with the probe, which is checked in the fibroscan, it changes. And if you treat the patient, the fibroscan score, which reflects the elasticity of the liver, it changes and it shows you that there was a block. Yes?
In start of the lecture, you were telling that Rakta is blood. Rakta is blood. I mean, start of the lecture, you told that Rakta is blood. And you said that it's made of Rasa and Rakta Dhatu.
Rasa and Rakta.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Dhatu or not Dhatu?
Rakta Dhatu is included in the Rakta. But along with the Rakta Dhatu, the Rasa Dhatu is also there. When you call blood, the liquid part of the blood is coming into the Rasa Dhatu, and the corpuscular matter which is there, it comes under the Rakta Dhatu.
So how can we define Rakta Dhatu? This
that is there, no? ITP, when it happens, it is going into the corpuscular matter, the platelets are going down and you get the ITP. You can see different levels of marrow depression, low RBC levels in the hypertensives. And that is all the Rakta Dhatu Kshaya, as what mentioned in the Samprapti. Ah, yes, boli. Yeah. Ah. Rakta Dhara Kala has been mentioned in the texts.
Exactly, but what is the concept of it? Because it's a very confusing topic, and to apply that and understand.
Kala, just see that.
Kala is a dhatva shayantara maryada. That's what is told. If you read the books in your curriculum, which are being used for more than 110 years, they will confuse you. Because the writers are confused. Don't keep anything in your mind. Use it blindly, or you think it blindly or blankly. Dhatva shayantara maryada. Correct? This is kala. And the mouse, when you cut, that's what the Sushruta has mentioned in the Raktadhara kala. When the mausa is cut, it is seen in the mausa piercing. And that is the raktadharakala, the inner membrane of the capillaries and veins even. Is the place where you can say that the most inner layer of the capillaries and veins flowing in the mausa is the raktadharakala.
So it's only a structural component and not a functional component, sir?
Not a functional. It's a structural thing.
Okay.
That's why it has been added in the anatomy, not physiology. Yes? For excessive bleeding or DUB, that I confirm. Due to bleeding disorders or the heavy bleeding, if she has undergone hysterectomy, she is going to show you Raktapitta symptoms, all the upadravas. The symptoms, you got the organ blocked. You got the organ removed. It was adhogarakta pitta, was to be treated as adhogarakta pitta and was not treated as adhogarakta pitta. Correct? Samprapti was somewhere else in the all shonitavaya srotasa. And you removed the vyakti sthana only. What happened? If you block, you imagine a flowing water, correct? You block it somewhere. What happens? It grows back. It grows back and it pierces laterally in all the surrounding area. The same thing happens. The samprapti is there. You have not cured the samprapti. You have just removed the outlet and it's going to hit you. You can get this one.
Can you explain again about Svarabheda? About Svarabheda. Svarabheda.
Svarabheda. Hoarseness of voice.
No, elaborate please somehow. Means how can we see in a patient that, yes, here I have Svarabheda?
Just see the note coming out of his throat. You can hear his voice.
Mm-hmm.
And if it gets more bass, he is having Svarabheda.
So Svarabheda is showing that he is having Raktapitta?
The bass vein increases unknowingly and the patient is not able to control. You try, ask him to sing. You ask him to sing,
mm-hmm,
and he will show you what is Svarabheda. He can't raise his voice easily.
Okay. And one more. Once you showed an example how a woman in the park was going like this, something.
Swaying walk.
Yeah, so it is also showing that she's having Raktapitta. It is also showing that she's having
Raktapitta. You just go and ask any woman walking like that if she is hypertensive or not.
Okay.
She will tell you. Simple idea. That doesn't require me.
Sir, is Shonita... Sir, Sir, is Shonita ja roga is a much more serious condition than Rakthapitta?
See, Shonita ja roga, there is a good long list.
Yes.
Of diseases which can go medicine resistant.
Yes.
That's a list of medicine resistant disorders, or the disorders which can go into medicine resistant state. And that include a lot many ideas.
Yes.
And all of them are, when only when they are medicine resistant, they are to be called Shonitaja. Otherwise they are treatable by normal treatment.
Okay.
Raktapittam, Asrugdaraha, that you asked. Raktapittam, Asrugdaraha, next is Asrugdara. Asrugdara, that's DUB. What you call. So that Asrugdara is a situation which can go medicine resistant, and that's why even in spite of giving the hormones, the bleeding is not controlled, and the doctor advises just remove the thing. But at that point, you need to intervene. No, sir, this is medicine resistance. And the medicine should be changed. If you change the medicine, break the resistance, the DUB is not going to be there. It's going to respond to the treatment. Correct?
Yes.
Long, long list. Swapna darshanam, mukhapako, akshiragaha. This all comes in the raktaja roga. Mukha daurgandhya, asya daurgandhya, sharira daurgandhya, Stavalya, what not? Everything included there. All these things can go medicine resistant. Always bear in the mind. As soon as there came a patient to me with a history of 17 years of recurrent stomatitis. Came just for stomatitis. And I gave him medicines, normal. His pachana was not going correctly. And when that was seen, I asked him to do the anti-CCP antibodies. They came positive. And then I said, for this stomatitis, I have to give you basti. Because the medicine given to you orally is not working on you. I have no other alternative rather than to give you the basti. And then he was confused. This simple thing like stomatitis, I take medicine, I get cured for a few days, again it recurs, and he is asking me to take basti for stomatitis. But no. If he wants a cure, the anti-CCP antibodies must be broken, and then only he can be cured of the stomatitis, mukhapako.
Yes.
And this is medicine resistant mukhapaka, for which you have to give basti. Just like that. Huh? Hypotension. Hypotension, भूखा कैसे चलेगा? भूखा प्यासा जैसे चलता है ना, थका हुआ. वो मतलब पहली नजर में तुम पता नहीं कर सकते कि हाइपोटेंसिव है या शराब पिया हुआ है. ज्ञान बातु करम चल लो. सॉरी, थोड़ा अलग लैंग्वेज में हो गया. वो कभी इधर जाए, कभी उधर जाए, कभी सीधा चला जाएगा, कभी एकदम भाग के जाएगा, कभी रुकेगा, नॉट एबल टू थिंक, गिरा रहेगा, नॉट एबल टू अटर वर्ड्स इवन इन द सीवियर हाइपोटेंशन. And there the treatment is क्या ट्रीटमेंट दोगे? इमरजेंसी है, somebody lies walking on the road and lies in front of you on the road, not able to talk, irrelevant talk, not able to answer, not able to concentrate, pulse feeble, what you will do? ग्लूकोज लाने तक वो बेहोश हो जाएगा. अनलेस एंड अंटिल यू परचेज द ग्लूकोज एंड गिव हिम, ही विल फेंट, ही विल गो इन टू अनकॉन्शियसनेस. वट इज द थिंग इमीजिएटली यू कैन डू? Give him adrenaline. Give him adrenaline. And now you ask me, there is no time to give glucose and you have time to give adrenaline. The adrenaline is in his body. You have to release it. Do jhapad laga do. Immediately his body releases adrenaline, his vessels contract, his volume and all the things match, and he starts walking. Then you can give him as many things you want. Sharbat pilao, glucose pilao, sharab pilao, kuch bhi pilao. But ek jhapad marna mat bhulo. Because that is the point, you have to stop him going into unconsciousness. Any fatigue, any shock, any hypotensive attack, do one thing first, give a good hit. Ek do daat to kam se kam girne chahiye. It should be a strong blow. Because adrenaline is released by fright, flight and fight. So you can't fight with him, you can't frighten him, just give him some adrenaline and he breathes normally. हमारे इसमें एक बंदा आता था साला जामनगर में, थोड़ा सा sorry for the English knowing. वो सिगरेट पीने का रोज का बीड़ी वो, और उसका ब्रोंकल कंजेशन में जाने का शैलो ब्रीदिंग. उसको चार बार बोला, साले तेरा बीड़ी बंद कर नहीं तो एक दिन तेरे को पकड़ के ऊपर से नीचे फेंकेगा. माना नहीं रोज का बीड़ी पीने का. एक दिन सुबह सुबह मेरे को कॉल आया, सर ऐसा लगता है वो मरेगा, शैलो ब्रीदिंग हो गई है. मैंने कहा रुक जरा आता हूँ, साले इतना जल्दी नहीं मरने वाला. वो मेरे साथ लोगों ने मेरे बॉस को भी कॉल भेज दिया था कि पेशेंट बहुत सीरियस है, शैलो, टोटली शैलो ब्रीदिंग, जैसे वैसे उसका सांस ट्रकिया तक जा रहा है और अंदर जा ही नहीं रहा है, ऑलमोस्ट लंग कोलैप्स. मैं दौड़ता हुआ पहुंचा, तब तक सर भी मेरे बॉस. बॉस बोले यार इसको एड्रेनालिन देनी पड़ेगी तभी ये सुधरेगा, अदरवाइज ये मरा. मैंने कहा क्या कहा आपने? एड्रेनालिन देनी पड़ेगी. एग्जैक्टली आई वॉज थिंकिंग द सेम. बॉस मेरे बारे में बहुत शंकित था, उसको पता था कि ये कुछ भी कर सकता है. क्या करने जा रहे हो? मैंने कहा कुछ नहीं. आप जरा खिड़की तक जाके देखो नीचे कौन आ रहा है, तब तक मैं इसको एड्रेनालिन देता हूं. बॉस को खिड़की तक भेजा और जैसे ही बॉस खिड़की से नीचे झांकने लगा एक इतनी जोर से बजा दी उसकी कि एक दांत गिर गया, मगर द इफेक्ट वॉज स्टनिंग। एक झापड़ मारते ही उसने पूरी दम लगा के सांस अंदर खींचा एंड हिज लंग्स स्टार्टेड वर्किंग, नो ब्रोंकोस्पैज़म, इंस्टेंट एड्रेनालिन। बॉस ने कहा साले मेरे को पता ही था तू मारेगा इसको। बोले आप क्या करोगे, आप क्या करोगे? मैंने कहा पेपर दे दो इधर, मैं करता हूं ना, कुछ करना है मेरे को पेपर पे। डिस्चार्ज फॉर बिहेवियर अगेंस्ट मेडिकल एडवाइस। इंस्टेंटली ब्रदर को बोला इसको इसकी बीड़ी का बंडल और इसके कपड़े फेंको इसके ऊपर, साले को 2 मिनट के अंदर बाहर निकलना चाहिए हॉस्पिटल से, ये बिल्कुल हॉस्पिटल में नहीं रहेगा। डिस्चार्ज फॉर बिहेवियर अगेंस्ट मेडिकल एडवाइस, बराबर ना, नथिंग एल्स टू बी डन। ये ऐसे लोगों की सीधी के बगैर वो मानते ही नहीं है। नॉट टू बी एडमिटेड, उसका नाम लिख के ले लो, दिस पेशेंट शुड नेवर बी एडमिटेड इन दिस हॉस्पिटल वंस मोर। उसको ठीक होना ही नहीं है, दाल रोटी खा के साला बीड़ी पीने के लिए यहां रुकने की क्या जरूरत है, मुफ्त का हॉस्पिटल है क्या? यस वंस मोर, हा हिमोफिलिया है ना, रक्तपित्त ही है भैया। वो श्लोक तेरे को दिखाया ना, वैडूर्य मुक्ता मणिगैरी का नाम। यूज इट, वैडूर्य मुक्ता मणिगैरी का नाम, दे आर ऑल द कोएगुलेंट्स यू हैव टू यूज, यू हैव टू रिप्लेस। मगर हिमोफिलिया है, इसका मतलब पक्का है कि वो रक्तपित्त ही है और वो तुम जितने भी एंटी उसको कोएगुलेंट्स दोगे ब्लड रुकेगी इमीडिएटली, मगर वो वापस उसी में जाने वाला है, इसलिए उसको विरेक विरेचन करके पूरा पित्त बाहर निकालने की जरूरत है, शोधन की अपेक्षा है, और उसके बाद अगर तुम उसका वो कोएगुलेंट सारे उसको सप्लाई करते रहते हो जो भी उसके लिए जरूरत है, ही इज क्योर्ड। Yes.
You were mentioning about rasa, which has two types, which one is an atvak and one is an koshta. It's about sthayi and asthayi rasa dhatu, or it's
sthayi rasa dhatu and koshtastha rasa dhatu. These are the two ideas.
Koshtastha means which is not undergone pachana with rasa.
It is there, uh-huh. But it works as a pool for many molecules in the circulating idea. Your circulating blood is a pool of many molecules. Some are nourishing, some are toxic, some are non-toxic, some are nourishing to the rakta dhatu, some are nourishing to the mausa dhatu, some are nourishing to the asthi dhatu, majja, shukra, everywhere. That a common pool is there, and that pool is called as the koshtastha rasa, and that is also included in the circulating fluid. तस्योष्मणा द्रव्य धातु धातोर धातो प्रसिच्यते। इफ यू गिव स्नेहन सम स्नेहन एंड हीट द बॉडी यू क्रिएट द प्रोटीन्स इन द प्रोटीन एक्सचेंज इन द रक्तधारा कला मोर इजी and muscle breakdown is a quite evident idea, especially this occurs when the atisantarpanatha rakta pitta, the man consuming more fats is getting the snigdha, sweda. There the muscle proteins break down with the fat and they are being secreted into the blood or transferred into the blood along with the fat. And this is called as tasyoshmana drava dhatu dhator dhato prasichyate. When the fat liquefies, it tries to get into the blood rather than outside the vessels. Correct? And for this reason, my friends, they are opting vidhi in the vamana and virechana, that they start the snehapana and they start the bahya sneha sveda at the same time. This is the most worst idea in the world. Kyunki sneha pita is asvedya. Sneha pita is asvedya. That's why the sneha pita is called asvedya. You have to start the external heat and the external snehana only after you complete the snehana process. Otherwise, you are creating rakta pitta. Correct? And in that case, the protein loss in the virechana or the vamana is very drastic and you feel a lot of headache side effects in the patient, and the patient takes long time to recover after his virechana and vamana. Where I follow the textual process, after having the 30 vegas of virechana, the patient walks into my OPD in the evening. Sir, I am fresh. No fatigue. Because I follow the textual way. Sneha, complete. Then only snehana svedana outside. Then the vamana or virechana. Correct? So, this is the physiology behind sneha pitasya svedanam. Sneha pitasya svedanam na karyam. He is a svedya. करना है कुछ भी पढ़ते हैं किताब में लिखा है शायद तुमको मालूम नहीं तुम्हारी पंचकर्म की किताबें लिखने वाले जितने भी बड़े आचार्य डुड्डाचार्य है ना उस साले सब के सब जामनगर में फर्स्ट ईयर में थर्ड ईयर में एक एक गच्चा खाए हुए हैं सब के सब एक भी सीधा नहीं है गच्चा तो मैं भी खाया हूँ फर्स्ट ईयर में इसलिए जैसे ही मैं फेल हो गया फर्स्ट ईयर में तब सबने बताया सर यू विल बी अ गुड ऑथर यू राइट मेनी बुक्स बिकॉज दिस इज द हिस्ट्री ऑफ जामनगर इंस्टीट्यूट दैट हूएवर गेट्स अ फेल राइट्स मेनी बुक्स एंड फॉर दैट पर्पज आई हैव नॉट रिटन अ सिंगल बुक आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू कि कोई ये कहे कि साला ये भी गच्चा खाया हुआ है राइट एनी मोर
सर यू वेर एक्सप्लेनिंग द टेपरिंग डोज ऑफ हाइपरटेंसिव मेडिसिन हाउ टू टेपर द डोज ऑफ हाइपरटेंसिव मेडिसिन एलोपैथिक मेडिसिन वुड यू एक्सप्लेन इट वंस मोर
व्हाट टाइप ऑफ मेडिकेशन योर पेशेंट इज टेकिंग First study that. सामने वाला क्या खेल रहा है ये जब तुमको पता हो तभी तुम उसकी टांग खींच सकते हो ना
नहीं ऐसा नहीं
पहले उसके दांव क्या है और कहां पे काम कर रहा है ये देखो उसमें से ट्राई ये करो कि लीस्ट टॉक्सिक जो मेडिसिन है उसको कंटिन्यू करो जो मोस्ट टॉक्सिक है उसको सबसे पहले बंद करो वर्किंग If you want, you can stop the medicines all of a sudden even because you have a potential tool of raktamokshana. Volume drain off. Simply drain off. Volume overload, simply drain off. Otherwise, you have other way.
Virechana.
Not virechana. Virechana means some purgative, not like that. the purgatives that increase the colonic secretion, and thus they work as the purgative, not affecting the ganglia supplying the colon. You need those medicines like
Jaipala.
No, that is irritant purgative. Trivrat. One more. Tikta, not Aragvada. Aragvada is sramsana, not virechana. Aragvada is sramsana, not virechana. Kutuki. Katuki, Trivrat. Then? Not really. But yes, somewhat acceptable. No, not, never. If you feel instant result to be given, Haritaki doshanulomani, not virechani, is doshanulomana.
Snuhi?
Some idea about Snuhi. Yes, it is, but it's irritant. It's irritant. I can't differentiate much between Snuhi and Jaipala. Huh? Danti. Correct? Mm-hmm. Correct. Little irritant, but increasing the colonic secretion. And sabse bhayanak dawa? Indrayan. Not Indrayava, man. Indrayana. That is the horrible medicine which is able to produce 50 ml of kashaya of Indrayana. Yes. Minimum 8 times purgation with a lot of volume drain off. Known toxin. You must be watching his heart rate every now and then when you give Indravana. Because?
Yes.
Because schedule H medicine only to be given in front of a knowledgeable consultant, never behind him. Patient dies of cardiac inertia. Patient dies of cardiac inertia. Anything more you have?
Sir, I wanted to share a case.
Huh? Bolo.
Now the patient is diagnosed as schizophrenic.
Schizophrenia? No problem.
But when I was reading these Lakshana Shonitaja Rogas, I could identify that most of the patient had most of these symptoms. And
I
now
never start the treatment with Shonita Prasadana.
No.
That is the problem of psychiatrists.
Yes.
Because they are themselves psychiatrists.
And
yes, you can do that.
Yes.
You can give the Tikshna Virechana, you can give the Snehana, Pachana, Basti, even if you want, and you can get the patient out of schizophrenia even. Rakta Mokshana, always, always prefer. At the Shankha Pradesha, keep on Jaloka, patient starts talking normally. Sravanam Shonitasya Chya. This Chya is a very, very critical word in Charak Samhita. If you understand the Chya in the Charak Samhita, you are the masters. If you don't know the meaning of the Charak Samhita, Chya in the Charak Samhita, you are nothing in the world. Because this person has not at randomly added cha to any word. The all words which he has added cha are special. So always give it 1,000 considerations more before interpreting. This cha is? Anybody doing MD in Sanhita or something like that? What is cha? In which year you are studying? Second year. Which college? Hassan? Achha, wo Girish ke paas ho? Achha. This charak, cha in the Charaka Sanhita represents the Brahmana Vashishtha Nyaya. This cha in the Charaka Sanhita represents the Brahmana Vashishtha Nyaya. Now don't ask what is Brahmana Vashishtha. Brahmanebhyo dadhim dadya takram tu vashishtebhyo. This is the classical description. This comes in the Mahabharata. Brahmanebhyo dadhim dadya takram tu vashishtebhyo. What does it mean? What you understand out of that?
We should prioritize.
Yes, the priority change. The consideration changed. The orientation must change as soon as you attach the word cha to anything. Even if written like the swarabheda, swarabhedas cha. That cha means that is number one. Though written at the end, it is to be taken as number one. That is Brahmana Vashishta. So what you understand? By the explanation, Brahmanebhyo dadhim dadyat takram tu vashishtebhyo. Vashishta is also a Brahmin. When you call Brahmanebhyo dadhim dadyat, Vashishta is also included. Then, why you say takram tu vashishtebhyo? Because though he is a Brahman, he is separate, he is different, he is special. That's why takram tu vashishtebhyo. Vashishta ko takra hi dena hai, Brahman ko dadhi de do. Correct? This is the meaning of cha. And this is to be applied everywhere the cha is added. This is a simple thing, or rather a method to read and understand the Sanhitas.
Sir, then is it the Buddhe Sammoha that explained in this?
Buddhe Sammoha is what you call as schizophrenia, ma'am.
Sir, then how do we differentiate, like whether it is Unmada or?
रक्त शुद्धि का चिकित्सा चालू करो. रक्त शुद्धि का चिकित्सा चालू करने के बाद अगर बुद्धे सम्मोह कम नहीं होता है तो
उन्माद
स्टिल डेंजरस आइडिया. देन थिंक ऑफ डिप्रेशन. Katham ashmalam idam. Got it? Gandhi vam sravsate karat karke Arjun baith gaya. To prahasanyo bhagavant ne katha. Katham ashmalam idam tvam parigatam. Pahle usko do laate maro. Ki sale kya kar raha? Wahi bhagavan ne kiya. Has diye? ऐसा ले इतना नहीं आता तेरे को क्या. दस पंद्रह लोग सामने देखे नहीं तो तू हाथ छोड़ के गांडी छोड़ के बैठ गया. क्या मतलब है तेरे होने का? ऐसे ही चालू किया ना. प्रबोधन करो. एंड इवन आफ्टर दैट ही इज नॉट रिस्पॉन्डिंग correctly, do go for a shodhana.
Okay.
Do go for shodhana.
Thank you, sir.
Stepwise approach that will pay you in the clinic. Clear understanding which is to be there, otherwise you make a mess. Otherwise you make a mess. So, Shastram Jyoti Prakashartham Darshanam Buddhiratmana Darshanam Buddhi Darshanam Atmanaha. Enlighten yourself first, then you can Rogansh Chikitsati. Otherwise, Nasa Rogansh Chikitsati.
Sir, ye jo sequence bataye iska bhi koi importance hai kya?
Sequence to maine tumko kuch point bataye hai, pura protocol nahi bataya.
Nahi sir, ye jo lakshan jo bataye jaise mukha paak akshiraga puti ghranasya gandhat.
Wo to hai, tabhi to bataya. But it's a long list, so can't predict iske baad ye kyun diya, iske baad yehi kaam ye karengi na, ye kuch nahi karti hai. बैठ गए ऐसा क्यों है वैसा क्यों है इसके जवाब इनको पूछना बट एनीथिंग एल्स व्हाट आर मींस यू वांट इमरजेंसी ट्रीटमेंट यू मीन फॉर ब्लीडिंग To stop the bleeding, a list of medicines is given. If not working, then pratimargam charayam raktapittam vidhiyate. If he is vomiting blood, induce purgation. If the DUB is there, you want to stop, induce vamana. Not 6 to 7 vamana are not needed. Just a couple of vamana, the DUB stops. That's it for bleeding, for coagulating disorders. I told you kshara in the form of lepana, kshara in the form of pana, kshara in the form of basti, anything you can do. All these are emergency treatments. And if you are ready, prepare the medicine in injectable form. Dilute with 1 cc, 2 cc distilled water, give intravenously. In the nearest part where the block is, you can see. Block in the artery, spot the block, enter the vein, nearest vein, just inject, the block will be gone.